Remember that pesky and nosy neighborhood auntie whose favorite pastime is to get everyone married and she has loads of free time on her hand? Well, Netflix ka jo naya show hai, Indian Matchmaking, it's full 8 episodes of this auntie and a lot of other stereotypes of the Indian arranged marriage market. I'm Ronak Kotecha aur ye hai review Netflix India ke naye show Indian Matchmaking ka featuring Seema Taparia. Mumbai ke Worli ilake mein rehne wali ye high profile Indian matchmaker presumably is the number one in the country. She often jet sets off to the US to her high profile NRI clients, and in India of course she has the only affluent clients from the upper class, upper caste, looking for a suitable match for their girl or a boy. But there is fun to be had in this show. It is entertaining, it is amusing, it is quirky with a lot of characters, but at the same time it's very regressive, I'm telling you right away. Sabse pehle to directed by an Oscar nominated short film maker Smriti Mundra. ये शो ज़्यादा करके केटर करता है ऐसे NRIs को जो US में रहते हैं और उनको इंडियन कल्चर के बारे में सैडली अब भी ज़्यादा नहीं पता है. दे थिंक अबाउट इंडिया इन अ सर्टन वे, स्पेशली व्हेन इट कम्स टू अरेंज मैरिजेस. तो व्हाट इज़ द शो ऑल अबाउट? वेल, इट्स एक्चुअली अ डॉक्यू सीरीज मीट्स रियलिटी मीट्स वेरी स्क्रिप्टेड सॉर्ट ऑफ अ शो, जहाँ पर ये जो सीमा तपारिया है, जो इंडियन मैच मेकर है, शी इज़ द मेन लाइक द सेंटर पॉइंट ऑफ द शो. शी इज़ द नरेटर एंड शी काइंड ऑफ जस्ट गोज इन टू वॉल्स इन टू द हाउसेज ऑफ हर क्लाइंट्स विद बायो डेटास एंड शी ट्राइज टू अंडरस्टैंड कि जो लड़का और लड़की उनकी क्राइटेरिया क्या है अपने होने वाले फ्यूचर हस्बैंड या वाइफ के लिए, और अपने टिपिकल सारी क्राइटेरिया बताते हैं. एंड देन शी पुल्स आउट प्रोफाइल्स आफ्टर प्रोफाइल्स एंड टेल देम इसके साथ शादी कर लो, इसके साथ मिल लो, मिलने में क्या हर्ज है, और इसकी स्माइल आपके साथ मैच कर जाएगी, इसकी हाइट आपके साथ मैच कर जाएगी, मुझे लगता है कि आप दोनों अच्छे मैच होंगे बिकॉज आप दोनों एक ही फील्ड से हो. एंड इट डजंट स्टॉप एट दैट, शी एक्चुअली इवन गोज टू अ फेस रीडर जो सिर्फ मोबाइल में फोटोज देखकर लड़के और लड़की के बता देते कि इनको ट्विन्स होने वाला है या ये कैसे हैं लाइफ में और कैसे इनकी लाइफ आगे बढ़ने वाली है और शादी होनी चाहिए कि नहीं. ऑफकोर्स इज अ लॉट ऑफ कुंडलीज एंड योग एंड एवरीथिंग दैट थ्रोन इन टू द मिक्स एंड इट्स अ टिपिकल इंडियन पॉट बॉयलर व्हेन इट कम्स टू अरेंज मैरिज सेट. इसमें बहुत सारी रिग्रेसिव जो एज ओल्ड आइडियाज है अरेंज मैरिज को लेकर वो दिखाई गई है, उसको ग्लोरीफाई किया गया और ये दिखाया गया है दैट अरेंज मैरिज इज मोस्टली लाइक द रेसिपी फॉर अ सक्सेसफुल शादी. इन द प्रोसेस ये शो क्या करता है कि जितनी भी कास्टिस्ट, कलरिस्ट, बॉडी शेमिंग वाली चीज़ें हैं और जितनी भी ऐसी दक्यालूसी चीज़ें हैं उनको बहुत ही कैजुअली ये दिखाता है. एंड एट सम पॉइंट्स इवन सेलिब्रेट्स एंड ग्लोरीफाइज इट, व्हिच इज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम दैट मोस्ट क्रिटिक्स आई हैव इन एंड इवन आई हैड, बिकॉज this is exactly what the young India has long divorced. We do not all think that arranged marriage is the be all and end all of everything. At the same time, yes, the show is also trying to show that arranged marriages do work because a lot of older couples have been together for the longest time, but that's not the way the young India thinks that you should first get married and then fall in love. But this show exactly shows that. And the problem is thought process ka koi counter view nahi dikhaya gaya hai, especially through Seema Taparia, who just walks into the people's lives. They presumably want her in their lives and she is judgmental, and then she goes and tells them that especially the women clients that they should compromise at any given opportunity. Even to men she says that, you know, you have to do a certain things because there's society pressure, and she is there of course and she'll make everything right, but a lot of times a lot of stories in the show are abruptly cut and you don't really see whether she has made it right or wrong. Actually she sends them on dates with her very limited knowledge of human relationships, because कहीं पर भी शो में ये क्लियर नहीं किया गया कि ये इसके पास इतनी एक्सपर्टीज आई कहाँ से टू एक्चुअली मेक दीज मैचेस. ओनली थिंग दैट शी हैज़ शी गोज ऑन ट्रेलिंग पीपल दैट आई एम सीमा तपारिया फ्रॉम मुंबई, एंड देन विदाउट इवन आस्किंग शी टेल्स पीपल दैट आई हैव बीन मैरिड फॉर सम 43-45 ईयर्स, विच एवरी अदर इंडियन पेरेंट और एवरी अदर इंडियन कपल इज. And if that's the criteria, then all of them are marriage experts, which in a way actually they are, because everybody behaves like that in India. So, इस पूरे चीज़ को काफ़ी glorify casually और बहुत ही you know normal तरीके से दिखाया गया that you have to accept it the way it is, which is the problem because most of the people cannot accept it. Now, where's the fun that I was talking about? The fun is when these guys meet, like, you know, when the girls and the guy meets and then they go on a date, and then what happens? These lot of these dates are also unpredictable, जहाँ पर आपको लगेगा कि हाँ it's a good match, but it probably wouldn't, and the show doesn't shy away from actually showing you that the match did not work out. And most of these stories also very relatable, because a lot of us have gone on dates and we have met people for the first time, we've tried to like understand them, things don't work out, maybe things work out for a while and after that they don't. So ye sari cheeze dekhne mein maza aata hai. I only wish ke सारी जो स्टोरीज हैं उनका एक डेफिनेट कंक्लूजन दिया गया होता, वो नहीं दिया गया है. दूसरी बात ये कि सीमा तपारिया का जहाँ तक रोल है, इट्स ऑल्सो इट इज़ रिग्रेसिव in lot many ways, and she actually peddles these thoughts so unabashedly that it's kind of cringe-worthy a lot of times, but at the same time it's also very quirky, and you want to see this auntie on a mission marriage, and she just goes about it without any qualms, without being countered at any given point in time. Like in one episode she goes to a divorcee and she gets another divorcee match for her in the US, and the girl's father is a little progressive and he's like, no, why should she just get married because of certain impediment in her life, which you think is divorce. She won't. Because he wants to know ke wo jo ladka hai, usne kyun divorce kiya apni pehli wife ko. And Seema Tapara is trying to just brush it under the carpet by saying ke nahi nahi, wo matlab unki wavelength nahi jami, aisa kuch tha. Like she doesn't even do the basic homework of knowing ke why one of her clients got divorced. And then she's just going ahead and proposing this client to her other client, because in my mind, when I was watching the show, it really came across as Seema Taparia was just interested in making her quick buck by getting two people hooked. And ironically, itna hokar bhi show mein kahin bhi ye nahi bataya gaya ki isko paise kitne milte hain, kahan se milte hain. She's just jet-setting off to the US in every other episode. She's wearing like these really cool clothes, and then she's flying across everywhere, and she's always available 24/7 on video call, in person. She's giving them advices. She's unsolicited, most of it. And she's also referring them to relationship counselors. Sab kuch kar rahi hai, and she's always there for them, but you never know how much she's charging. But my guess is that she must be charging them a bomb, because going by the affluency of the clients that she has and the kind of self-entitlement that she shows in the show, I'm sure that it's real. In the real life, she's just like that. And unka actually suitable rishta karke unki ek company bhi hai jahan par yahi kaam hota hai, of course. But all of it to watch is very amusing, but to actually believe in it and practice in real life is very scary. Well, ye tha mera take about Indian matchmaking. Aise shows humne pehle bhi dekhe hain. Well, it's not like Netflix has come up with something really very novel. Matlab 2001 mein Madhuri Dixit ka Shubh Vivah karke ek show aaya tha jo Sony Entertainment Television pe aata tha. Wo exactly aisa hi tha jahan pe bride and groom hote hain, puri family hoti hai. Family ka bhi bahut sara say hota hai arranged marriages mein, because according to arranged marriage ka jo ethos hai, two families are getting married and not just the girl and the boy. The Bachelor करके जो show है वो भी कुछ हद तक ऐसा ही है जहाँ पर लड़के लड़कियाँ डेट पे जाती हैं, all that. So it's a kind of a The Bachelor meet Shubh Vivah sort of a setting, but in a very snazzy, high production values and you know, like a typical Netflix का जो rich looking show होता है वैसा ये है. और show का जो background score है, that also starts getting progressively perky and cooler, but sadly the thought process, the belief of the show doesn't get any cooler as it progresses. In fact, the filmmaker is more interested in showing the NRI crowd what Indian culture is in a very skewed way. So that's my take on Netflix India ka naya show Indian Matchmaking. Pros and cons मैंने आपको बता दिए. Times of India में भी मैंने इसका review किया है, आप पढ़ सकते हो. Link मैंने डाल दिया description में और comment में. And of course, if you like my reviews and videos, please subscribe, and you can meet me on Instagram @ReviewRon. पर इससे भी ज़्यादा खास करके इस वाले review में मैं जानना चाहता हूँ कि आपका arranged marriage और love marriage को लेकर क्या thought है. आप क्या सोचते हो कि क्या पहले शादी होनी चाहिए और बाद में लव होना चाहिए? एंड डू यू थिंक दैट लव मैरिजेस आर वेरी फिकल, दे डोंट वर्क, और अरेंज मैरिजेस हैव दिस फुल प्रूफ मेथोडोलॉजी कि ये चली जाएगा? आजकल की इंडिया क्या सोचती है मुझे जानना है, आप मेरे कमेंट सेक्शन में बताइए. ऑल्सो ऑफकोर्स यू कैन टेल मी हाउ यू लाइक इंडियन मैच मेकिंग एज अ शो. थैंक यू सो मच, बाय.